lot of times we study the Bible, but it's good to study your Bible because the Bible brings out a hope for us, you know, and what it's going to bring for us. And let me show you this video because this video is really good. It's called Why Study the Bible.
Mm-hmm. From the moment we can talk, we ask questions. Why is the sky blue? What are the stars made of? Why do bad things happen? Where do we come from? Why do people die? People go to great lengths to find answers. Today, there is more information available than ever before.
And this advertised ad app, jw.org.
Questions about life, suffering, and death still remain. Where can we find answers? What if the answers have been there all along in the Bible? A lot of people say the Bible is full of myths and legends, but it's outdated. It's just too hard to understand. But is the Bible really the problem? Or is it what people think they know about the Bible? People think the Bible says that God controls the world. But how could that be? This world is out of control. It's full of pain. Suffering, sickness and death, poverty and disaster. How could a loving God be responsible for all of this? What the Bible says may surprise you. It says the evil one controls the whole world. In other words, there's an evil power behind the world's problems. Someone who's pulling the strings behind the scenes. That's why, no matter how hard we try,
we just cannot...
Stop it.
Who's the evil one?
You know who the evil one is? Satan. He controls this world. And that's why we have so many problems.
I heard that, and I know what scripture they're talking about, but it's not talking about Satan. It says, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. Right? So that's what they're getting that from. So he covereth the faces of the judges thereof, if not where and who is he? So who's the wicked?
1 John 5:19.
Let's get it.
I'd like to see a well-used Bible.
Yes. It says, and we know that we are of God, and the whole world lieth in wickedness. Okay, but that still goes back to this. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. Who is the wicked?
Bad people.
Look who's doing the stuff on the earth. Bad people. Ooh. They're the wicked. The wicked is the wicked stuff that's happening on the earth.
That's what we say is people with the Bible. It says, this is Malachi chapter 1, verse 4. It says, whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness, and the people against whom the Lord hath indignation forever. Now, when you read this, this is talking about what?
It says wickedness, but it's referred to people.
Hold on 1 second.
The people that God...
Hold on 1 second. Verse 4 says, whereas Edom saith. So this is talking about Edom. The people of Edom. Who is Edom today?
Interesting. You know, the Bible uses Edom very... in an interesting way to depict, because to represent, because Edom was the largest of the tribes at one point. So a lot of times when they says the Edomites, mm-hmm. talking to all of, about all of the Israelites. But I have to show you some references.
Well, let's think of what you said. Because Edom could not be describing Israel, because Esau is the father of Edom. So Esau and Jacob were born at the same time.
Oh, yes, I'm sorry.
Okay, so let me ask you this.
Ephraim.
Right, Ephraim is different. Mm-hmm. So Edom, who is he today?
I don't believe it's an individual who's representing non-believers.
It's not representing. It's Edom is the name of a people.
Oh, really? You believe that?
Of course. Same thing as Jacob is the name of a people, no? Does Israel is not the name of a people?
But we know that we're dealing with spiritual Israel now.
Where does it say that? Where is it in the Bible says spiritual Israel?
Oh, my goodness.
Please.
So many places.
Please.
To the Christians, Jesus said that they would lose their place. Mm-hmm. The Israelites, mm-hmm. in the first century, they would lose their place.
Oh, okay.
And he would replace them with a spiritual Israel.
Okay.
That happened in Pentecost of 33 CE. You don't believe that?
I don't believe it.
Okay. I wish I had my printed copy.
You can use my Bible if you want.
I need to.
It's going to make us look stupid.
Exactly.
So next time, use a goldfish.
Well, that's the thing. We heard that for a long time, but there's actually nowhere in the Bible that says spiritual Israel.
Oh, no, but the thought is there that they would be replaced by people. Even the Gentiles would be taken in among. Be taken into the fold. God's not dealing with only Israelites today.
Yes, he is.
Oh, okay. That we don't agree on. But yeah. I can definitely bring you something back to read about it.
Okay, look. We're talking about, like, say, the New Testament, right? Because that's where everybody gets this stuff from, right? But when you look at Hebrews, okay, where the New Testament is defined, you'll see that God is only dealing with Israel still, right?
You talking about Revelation?
No, I'm talking about Hebrews chapter 8.
Okay.
We can start in verse 8, right? It says, "For finding fault with them, mm-hmm. he saith, Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah." Mm-hmm. Who's that?
That's Israel.
No. Judah and Israel, these are the two nations, meaning the two kingdoms of Israel. So you had Judah, which was the southern kingdom, which was Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. Mm-hmm. Then you had Israel, which was the northern kingdom, starting with Ephraim, mm-hmm. and going down, all the other tribes. So those are the two nations that he's talking about. When you read the scriptures in that, in different places where it says the two nations and that other nation, another nation, mm-hmm. it's talking about the northern kingdom. It's not talking about everybody on the planet. But what's going on? It says, "Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers," letting you know that it's a physical thing. Okay? In the...
Write it on their hearts instead of that written law code.
Hold on.
That he had given
them. Don't jump yet. "Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day when I took them by the hand to lead them out of Egypt." So now you know they're talking about Israel. Plain.
Right.
Okay?
Not according to that. Right.
Hold on. Mm-hmm. You're adding.
You just read.
No.
You just read it.
"Not according to the covenant," meaning what? The old covenant.
Because
the old, not the law code, the old covenant was the law of sacrifice. Hold on a second.
Yeah. That's what the Bible always refers to the law covenant. It's Mosaic law.
Hold on. Mm-hmm. But the Mosaic law is still in effect.
Uh-oh.
Without the... Hold on. You got to listen. Because you're jumping. It's something that you were told, but you got to read.
Okay.
Right? "Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day when I took them by the hand to lead them out of the land of Egypt, mm-hmm. because they continued not in my covenant, and I regarded them not, saith the Lord. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel." Mm-hmm. Who's the house of Israel? No, it doesn't say that.
In that verse.
No.
All the Bible has to be taken in consideration.
Hold on. The whole Bible is taken in consideration because there's no contradiction. That's remember,
right.
he mentioned the fathers, so letting you know it's a physical thing.
Right.
Okay?
It wouldn't be like that one. This one would be written on the heart. Mm-hmm. And combine that with the scriptures that talk about him no longer dealing with them as a people exclusively, but everyone.
No, where does it say that is what I'm asking.
I can't believe you're asking me that.
I have to
okay,
ask.
Okay,
because this is what people say.
She.
Okay. So let me show you.
Yeah, deep.
Okay.
She got a scripture?
There's just so many references, I don't even know where to start.
We want scripture. See, because when you look at Romans 9, while you're looking, I'm just going to show you different things.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Romans 9 is, I mean, you can just go there and probably just go leave after. And I'm not saying you literally leave, I'm saying It says, I say the truth in Christ, I lie not. My conscience also bearing me witness in the Holy Ghost, that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow in my heart. But I could wish that I myself were accursed from Christ for my brethren, my kinsmen, according to the flesh. So this is Paul talking about his kinsmen, brethren, his family, literal flesh family, right? According to the flesh, who are Israelites, to whom pertaineth the adoption and the glory and the covenants, meaning the Old and New Testaments, okay? And the giving of the law and the service of God and the promises, okay? Whose are the fathers, and of whom, as concerning the flesh, Christ came? Letting you know that Christ came what? For Israel. Why? Because when you go into, and you know, precept must be upon precept, you have to go to different precepts.
The whole world, Jesus came for the whole world. That's initially for Israelites.
That's not the world that's being talked about. Let me show you something, and then we're going to deal with the world. Okay? Galatians chapter 4 and verse 4. But when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive adoption of sons. So who was under the law in the
Israelites
Old Testament?
Were. He was sent to them first.
Who was under the law?
The Israelites.
Good. Let's stop there. It says to redeem them that were under the law. Because those were the only people under the law. That's who Christ came to save. He didn't give the law to save the Chinese or whoever. He gave it to the Israelites.
But do you remember the scripture that says initially to them, they first came to speak to the house of Israel?
Sure. Okay. But that's dealing with, like I told
then
you before.
Then he sent them out to, and they were to cover the whole world. Matthew 28:19-20, it was to send them out to everyone.
Right.
All nations and tribes.
Because the Israelites were scattered throughout the earth.
Also, you don't think he was talking to other people?
No, he wasn't. I'm going to show you.
So in Pentecost of 33, when they came speaking all the different languages?
Okay. I'm going to show you.
Okay.
Especially in Pentecost, that was pretty... That was
just read it.
Yeah, that was the most clear one that he was talking only to Israel.
Okay.
The book of Pentecost, chapter 2 and verse 1. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men out of every nation under heaven.
Hold on.
Dwelling in Israel.
What was Pentecost?
Right.
Pentecost was a celebration that they had.
A celebration?
Mm-hmm.
A celebration?
A festival.
Or was it a law?
Right. Well, it was a law to have
okay.
that festival.
It was a holy day.
But there were many proselytes.
Wait a minute, wait. Why were all those people there for Feast of Pentecost?
For that.
Because three times a year, the Israelites were required to appear before the Lord. Okay. Did God give those laws to the other nations?
No, he didn't.
So why would there be other nations there?
But they came from wherever they were as proselytes.
What is a proselyte?
Proselyte is a believer and a convert. So I get what you're going.
So hold on, listen. Here's the history, man.
But he sent them out to all the nations.
What happened to Israel? When you read Deuteronomy, hold on for a second. When you read Deuteronomy the 28th chapter in the 64th verse, you read about the curses in the Bible. Israel was scattered throughout all nations of the earth because of our disobedience for not keeping God's laws. What happened was you had Israelites that was scattered throughout the whole world. You had devout Jews that were coming from places that, like where we were dwelling in our captivity. You had the Persian and Mede captivity, the Babylonian captivity, the Assyrian captivity. We came from a lot of different places. And what happened was, you still had to be there in Jerusalem. These were devout men. They kept the commandments. They knew three times a year they had to go. This was not talking about the other nations.
So when
Acts 2.
Sent them out to preach to a people of all the nations, you feel that was only Jews, like in Matthew 28:19-20.
Let's show you real quick. Give me Matthew 15:24. What you're going to come to find out, during the time of Christ, what tribes were there in Israel? When Christ came, what tribes were located there in Israel?
I think a variety. The Judah was definitely there. The Samaritans were descendants of the 10 tribe, northern kingdom.
You're right.
They were in Samaria.
Right. But there was a remnant of those Samaritans that were left. What happened to those northern tribes before? Let's get that real quick. Give me Ezra 1. You know what I want?
Yep.
Right. They were dispersed after what? The Persian and Mede captivity. You had people like, what was his name? Darius?
Yep.
Was it Darius or Cyrus that let him go?
Cyrus.
He freed us. He let all the tribes of Israel go. But the 10 tribes said, you know what? We're not going to go back to Jerusalem. We're going to go to a far country. Right. This is where what you know today as Hispanics and Native Americans today. Right. They said, we're going to go where never men dwelt before.
You want that one?
I want to read this first, just so she knows who was there in Jerusalem.
Okay.
Read that.
All right, Ezra 1, verse 1. Now in the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, that the word of the Lord by the mouth of Jeremiah might be fulfilled, that the Lord stirred up the spirit of Cyrus, king of Persia, that he made a proclamation throughout all his kingdom and put it also in writing, saying, thus saith Cyrus, king of Persia, the Lord God of heaven hath given me all the kingdoms of the earth, and he hath charged me to build a house at Jerusalem, which is in Judah.
Read.
Who is there among you of all his people? His God be with him, and let him go to Jerusalem, which is in Judah, and build the house of the Lord of God Israel. His God, which is in Jerusalem. And whosoever remaineth in any place where he sojourneth, let the men of his place help him with silver and with gold and with goods and with beasts, besides the free will offering for the house of God that is in Jerusalem.
Read on.
Then rose up the chief of the fathers of Judah and Benjamin.
So here rose up the chief of the fathers of Judah. Read.
And Benjamin.
And the priests, which were the Levites. Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. This is known today as the Southern Kingdom.
Right.
Even before this, you remember the kingdom split under Jeroboam and Rehoboam. After Solomon died, the Northern Kingdom left, and the Southern Kingdom stayed. The Northern Kingdom basically went to do their own thing. They said, what inheritance do we have? There's no kingship in us.
Right.
Y'all stick with that. And the other tribes basically went into idolatry.
Right.
So you believe that?
Those are the Gentiles that Christ was speaking of.
The 10 tribes.
Exactly. The Israelites called those people, those 10 tribes, Gentiles. Whenever you live like a Gentile and you don't do what the Most High said to do, you're referred to as a Gentile in the Bible. Let's prove that. Give me John 10.
Where? You want John 10? Okay.
Let me give you an example. Let's see what the Bible says.
You want to get Maccabees? You want to get Maccabees? I'll show them.
She's not going to accept Maccabees.
No. Okay.
Get John 10 real
quick. So you guys believe that you're Israelites?
We know who we are. We are the Israelites, and so are you. And we're glad you came to visit us today, because now you're learning you're an Israelite. Your history is in the Bible. We do more than that.
Oh, okay.
We do more than that.
In the method Jesus used.
We mean in the method, yeah. Jesus taught on the highways and the byways.
Everything.
Absolutely.
He also sent the 70 out,
2x2. 2x2, and that's exactly what we do. You'll see us out here handing out flyers. You'll see us out here talking to people.
I never see you.
Well, here in I'm not from L.A., but here in L.A., the body's actually growing. We have churches scattered throughout the world now.
No.
No?
No, we're Jews.
Read that real quick, John 10.
Yeah, we're not Muslim.
How'd she get to Muslim and we here talking about Christ?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, sister.
There's lots of Muslims who don't believe in Christ. We talked to a lot of people.
Okay, sis. We're going to make it plain. Hold on, sis. We don't live here.
Oh.
We don't live here. Okay. I live in New York.
Oh, I got the New York residency.
Okay. And so we come out to see our brothers today.
Okay.
And we're going to go, if y'all driving, we were here since Wednesday.
Oh.
But if y'all want to come down by the Staples Center, we'll be out there today preaching at the BET Awards.
I want to bring you the scriptures that just talk about Israel being replaced.
Israel is impossible. I'm going to show it to you.
So I'm going
to
bring a list of them because
you can't find one right now.
I can't. And you know what? Because I'm taking my tablet out for the
first time, right? You're supposed to be showing people the Bible.
I should. The Bible's in here. I need to have my own, I could flip and give you the verses.
Sis.
So how long will you be here?
Sis. The Israelites will never be replaced. Okay.
Well, I'm going to leave the verses here anyway.
Listen to this. This is Jeremiah 31 and 35. Mm-hmm. It says, thus saith the Lord, which giveth the sun for light by day, and the ordinances of the moon and of the stars for light by night, which divideth the sea when the waves thereof roar, the Lord of hosts is his name. If these ordinances depart from before me, okay? That means the sun, moon, the stars, and everything else, right? And we know they still here.
Mm-hmm.
All right? If these ordinances depart from before me, saith the Lord, then the seed of Israel also shall cease from being a nation before me forever. So Israel's always going to be here. The whole Bible, no. Sis.
There's no scripture in the Bible that says spiritual Israel. You're making that up.
Yes.
You're making that. You will never.
The end of this.
Before the end of, okay, right.
Put them in this door.
Why couldn't you find that right now?
Because I don't have my Bible.
It's not in there, sis.
Search it for you in it.
You can right now. You can Google it. Google. You got a phone. You can Google. Type in spiritual Israel.
See, but your machine, the device couldn't even find it because it doesn't exist.
We'll see. We'll see.
Sis, okay, it doesn't exist. Okay, we are a physical, real bloodline Israelites. Okay, okay. Sis, this is what it is. That's how we have to look at the Bible. You're looking at the Bible as, for instance,
well,
Jehovah Witnesses.
All of the scriptures
hold on
together,
a second,
taken together.
Hold on.
I understand if you read just that one.
No, sis. We read, no,
just the
sis,
ones that refer to sis, Israel as being,
sis,
as
we
being
read
God's
the
people
whole,
forever.
No, sis. Precept must be upon precept. So you have to know the Bible and be able
anytime,
to connect.
Anytime.
But let me say this to you.
Anyway, we're
okay,
going to take off. Can
I ask you a question? Why are Jehovah Witnesses so invasive until the Bible comes out?
Oh my goodness. We're
yeah. You try to leave right now. We opened the Bible up.
Right.
Brother opened the Bible up and now you want to go.
And I really commend you.
No, listen. The only reason we want to go is because we have.
You wouldn't
husband,
be going nowhere right now if I
no,
said I wanted
have,
to join
no, no,
the,
no,
the,
we have
the temple.
For
where's
second,
our husband?
Oh, he's right over there.
He should have been over here.
No, he just walked from another door.
That brother should have been here.
If we were sitting here saying, man, oh, glory to God, let's join the kingdom hall.
You
would have sat, y'all have sat down with us. We would have, had something to eat.
But
now the Bible came out. Now that
you,
now you want to leave, sis.
When will you be back?
Sis, we're gonna leave here like 2:30 today.
Okay.
And then we got work to do. But let me say this to you, sis, right before you leave. Why is it? I'm gonna ask you a question.
We love to use the Bible and use it.
We believe in the Heavenly Father of this Bible. So y'all use the Bible, so we believe in the same God, right? Let me ask you a question. Why is all the Jehovah Witness little books? How come we never seen Jesus as black on any of those books ever?
Jesus was Jewish.
Jesus was a Jew. Jesus was black.
Okay.
The Israelites were black. Now, all the Israelites are not black today. That's not what we're saying. But we're saying that in this book, it describes Christ as being dark-skinned in two areas. It describes many physical attributes of Christ, and none of them have him as a so-called what you call Jewish. Those people are not the real Jews. In the Bible, it tells you that. They even know it. We spoke to them. They know they're not the real Jews. Come
okay
on. They're converted.
Okay?
They're converted.
I still would like you to have those verses.
You gotta do some
back
research.
Listen. I will. Bring
that.
Take
she's
that.
The
you want to find out.
Not too many people. That's why you don't know that. That's why I'm not doing
it. Okay, well, if anybody wants to find out about us, you or them, we're called Israel United in Christ.
That's right.
Israel United in Christ. Okay, you look us up. We just had a debate against the two top what are those guys? Those so-called doctors of theology?
Yeah, doctor.
Down in
Texas,
Southwestern,
Terrell, Texas.
Southwestern College is a Bible college. Mm-hmm. Okay, these are the top men that are schooling all of the people who you learn from. They learn from these. Listen to what I'm saying. All of the Christian churches are combined in some way, shape, form, or fashion. Just hear me out. I'm not saying
no
directly.
No Trinity, no immortality of the soul, no hellfire, no once saved, always saved. Jehovah's Witnesses don't learn from theologians. We learn from the Bible.
Right.
We have a comparison of all the scriptures on one subject at a time.
I know.
Is there a reason why y'all have dresses on?
Right.
Well, we like to look our best for the work that is.
Mm.
Okay, so it's not because the law stating a woman is not to wear that which pertains to a man?
No.
Did you know that was in the Bible?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so is that why you wear dresses or is your women wear pants?
No, yes, I wear pants at other times.
Okay.
Yeah, we do wear pants.
Because pants
that's what's
now,
wrong. That's the problem with Jehovah's Witnesses.
Pants now are considered.
The laws have been made null and void. Y'all don't do Christmas, right?
No.
Why?
Because it's not. Why should we?
Okay, so what about the days that are in the Bible?
Because Jesus came to fulfill the law. If we keep doing the things of the law, we deny him.
So like murder.
He came to
homosexuality, right?
Well, no, of course. Cause the,
so how do you differentiate?
He replaced. Jesus said he came to the law of love,
mm-hmm,
right? So you wouldn't murder your neighbor if you loved them. You
okay. Them homosexuals is in love, right?
Them, right?
Them homosexuals is in love, aren't they?
That's right. But
so why is that wrong?
That particular one is restated.
Where?
1 Corinthians.
It's restated where?
In Corinthians.
What does it state?
Well, it says that men who lie
so
with men will
wait,
not
so you're saying because it wasn't, it has to be restated in the New Testament for you to keep it?
Under God's law.
Oh, okay. So y'all don't tithe.
Okay.
No, we don't tithe.
Why?
We don't. Because it's not restated.
Because it's not restated in the Bible. So
Christians are not under the Mosaic law.
Okay. So
Christians aren't under the laws of God. So Christ made up laws?
He made the law of love. And they restated in Corinthians certain things that we should continue
to law,
do.
The law of love was made in Exodus. Blood. The law of love, the Most High Himself brought that out in the book of Exodus,
so
chapter 20. We're just trying to let you know that what you're stating is incorrect.
Right.
The book of John, chapter 2, verse 10, verse 22, it says, and it was at Jerusalem, the feast of the dedication, and it was winter. Okay? And Jesus walked in the temple in Solomon's porch, meaning that what? Christ was keeping that feast as well.
Did.
So how come you don't keep it?
He did.
It was restated.
It was restated here in the New Testament.
His death.
It was restated.
He undid the law. He came to fulfill
undid it.
He came to fulfill it.
So he undid homosexuality.
No. It's in First Corinthians.
This is in John, the 10th chapter.
Yeah. Why would?
No, Jesus had not died yet.
Oh. So when he dies, that's when all of it.
Jesus followed the law himself.
Right?
But he came to fulfill it.
Hold on.
Why would he keep
all
the law?
All the law pointed to him.
Why would he keep the law if
he
doesn't want you to keep
that
it?
He took away. So no, remember the scripture says he wouldn't have to continually give sacrifices. He's going to be the one to fulfill it. Are you still doing this animal sacrifice?
Yes. So what about the Feast of Pentecost that they were keeping in Acts, the second chapter, after Christ died?
She said we'll be keeping animal sacrifice.
No,
we don't keep them. The state's not.
What about the Feast of Pentecost was after Christ? It's time to go now.
Yeah.
Huh? Shoot, come out, y'all ready? She said, hey. She said, hey, Pentecost, was that restated after Christ?
That was good. I was good.